so much. No, for me, I'm flexible. I can, of course, it is something I want to prioritize, of course. So no problem. Frankly, I think it could be a good opportunity. Of course, if the others cannot, you decide yourself. But really, feel free to
durante le fasi di decollo e atterraggio i vostri
thank you so much.
Che sui nostri voli non è consentito fumare.
I've been very busy. Okay, thank you, bye.
Je regagnais la Russie au commencement de la Première Guerre mondiale, en novembre 1914, après un voyage relativement long par l'Égypte, Ceylan et l'Inde. La guerre m'avait trouvé à Colombo, d'où je m'embarquais pour revenir par l'Angleterre. J'avais dit à mon départ de Saint-Pétersbourg que je partais en quête du miraculeux. Le miraculeux est très difficile à définir. Mais pour moi, ce mot avait un sens tout à fait défini. Il y avait déjà longtemps que j'étais arrivée à cette conclusion que, pour échapper au labyrinthe de contradictions dans lequel nous vivons, il fallait trouver une voie entièrement nouvelle, différente de tout ce que nous avions connu ou suivi jusqu'à présent. Mais où commençait cette voie nouvelle ou perdue? J'étais incapable de le dire. J'avais alors déjà reconnu comme un fait indéniable que, par-delà la fine pellicule de fausse réalité, il existait une autre réalité dont quelque chose nous séparait, pour une raison à préciser. Le miraculeux était la pénétration dans cette réalité inconnue. Et il me semblait que la voie vers cet inconnu pouvait être trouvée en Orient. Pourquoi en Orient? Il était difficile de le dire. Peut-être y avait-il dans cette idée une pointe de romantisme. Dans tous les cas, il y avait aussi la conviction que rien ne saurait être trouvé ici, en Europe. Pendant le voyage de retour et les quelques semaines que je passais à Londres, toutes les conclusions que j'avais tirées de ma recherche se trouvèrent bouleversées par l'absurdité sauvage de la guerre et par toutes les émotions qui étaient dans l'air, envahissaient les conversations, les journaux, et qui, contre ma volonté, m'affectèrent souvent.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome on board your EasyJet service, shortly now departing for London Gatwick. As we are operating a full flight this evening, we do kindly ask that you place only your large bags into the overhead lockers, wheels first, and keep all smaller items underneath the seat in front of you. These can include your backpacks, trunks, laptops, handbags, duty-free, as well as any loose items of clothing or coats. Once you've safely stowed your cabin baggage, please take your assigned seat. To help us ensure a nice prompt departure this evening, we do kindly ask that you keep the aisle clear, which enables your fellow passengers to board. Once seated, please do not...
I returned to Russia in November 1914, that is, at the beginning of the First World War, and after a rather long journey through Egypt, Ceylon and India. The war had found me in Colombo, and from there I went back through England. When leaving Petersburg at the start of my journey, I had said that I was going to seek the miraculous. The miraculous is very difficult to define, but for me this word had quite a definite meaning. I had come to the conclusion a long time ago that there was no escape from the labyrinth of contradictions in which we live, except by an entirely new road, unlike anything hitherto known or used by us. But where this new or forgotten road began, I was unable to say. I already knew then as an undoubted fact that beyond the thin film of false reality, there existed another reality from which, for some reason, something separated us. The miraculous was a penetration into this unknown reality, and it seemed to me that the way to the unknown could be found in the East. Why in the East? It was difficult to answer this. In this idea, there was perhaps something of romance, but it may have been the absolute real conviction that, in any case, nothing could be found in Europe. On the return journey and during the several weeks I spent in London, everything I had thought about the results of my search was thrown into confusion by the wild absurdity of war and by all the emotions which filled the air, conversation and newspapers, and which against my will often affected me.